So we proceed now to the components of the National Service Training Program or your NSTP. So we have three components of your NSTP. So first is the Reserve Officers Training Corps or your ROTC. Second is your Civic Welfare Training Service or your CWTS. And third is the Literacy Training Service or your LTS. Okay, so first is your ROTC. Okay, so ROTC refers to the program component institutionalized under Section 38 and 39 of Republic Act Number 7077, designed to provide military training to motivate, train, organize, and mobilize them for national defense preparedness. Okay, so the ROTC is designed to provide military training to tertiary level students in order to motivate, train, organize, and mobilize them for national defense preparedness. So it seeks to indoctrinate, train, and provide the ROTC cadets or cadets with the basic knowledge on military subjects and practical exercises that will enable them to acquire skills and capabilities to lead, move, survive, shoot, and communicate. Okay, so your ROTC also seeks to prepare college students for possible service in the defense establishment in the event of emergency. Okay, and also it seeks to train and develop the ROTC cadets or cadets as future enlisted reservists for the reserve component of the armed forces of the Philippines. Okay, so ROTC in the Philippines class is one of the three components of the NSTP. Okay, the Civic Education and Defense Preparedness Program for Filipino college students. Okay, so your ROTC aims to provide military education and training for students to mobilize them for national defense preparedness. Okay, so its specific objectives is to include preparation of college students for service in the armed forces of the Philippines in the event of an emergency, and okay, their training to become reservists and potential commissioned officers of the AFP. Okay, so graduates of the ROTC advanced program serve in all branches of the armed forces of the Philippines. Okay, the ROTC grants qualified student cadets or cadets scholarship benefits through a merit-based incentive program, but in return for an obligation of military service in the reserve force or active duty in the AFP if given the opportunity, okay, after graduation. Okay, so ROTC cadets or cadets attend college like other students, okay, but also receive basic military training and officer training from the branch of service that handles their school's ROTC unit, okay? So the students participate in regular ROTC instruction during the school year, okay? So one school year for basic ROTC and three school years for advanced ROTC, okay? So kung gusto nyong maging officer, okay, so there is a three school years, okay, advance. And there is also an extended training activities during the summer, such as ROTC summer camp training and the advanced ROTC academic pace training. Okay, so ROTC units in colleges and universities are organized through the Department of Military Science and Tactics, or that is your DMST, which is under joint supervision by the school administration and the Department of National Defense, or DND. These ROTC units class are in turn managed by active duty officers of the AFP and the reservist organization representatives of the major services, the Philippine Army Reserve Command of the Philippine Army, the Philippine Navy Reserve Command of the Philippine Navy, and the Philippine Air Force Reserve Command of the Philippine Air Force. So that is your ROTC. Okay, now how about your Civic Welfare Training Service, or your CWTS? So mag-focus tayo dito, class. Ano? So mag-focus tayo dito because you are under CWTS, or your Civic Welfare Training Service. So this refers to the program component or activities contributory to the general welfare and the betterment of life for the members of the community, or the enhancement of its facilities, especially those devoted to improving health, education, environment, entrepreneurship, safety, recreation, and moral of the citizenry and other social welfare services. Okay, so your CWTS class is one of the two NSTP program implemented by the Mariano Marcos State University. Okay, so the objectives of this program are, okay, so we have number one is to help students develop their nationalism by engaging to activities that centered on socio-civic efforts and community service. Okay, so another objective is to motivate, train, and organize you students as catalysts of change in the community. Okay, what else? So another objective of your CWTS is to harness and maximize the technical expertise and interests of different schools and departments and students' courses to benefit the underprivileged and economically poor sectors of the society. Okay? So, and most importantly, class, to develop each student to possess a what you call high level of social awareness. So those are the objectives of your CWTS. So CWTS, an NSTP component that makes us realize that it is not about fulfilling our academic requirements, but serving while we are still students. Okay, so usually for the community welfare which we all belong in. Okay. So before class, so may mga tinatawag tayong adapt a barangay program. So ang ginagawa, pumupunta yon ang mga estudyante sa isang barangay, nag-adapt sila ng community, and then may i-develop sila doon. Okay, may i-develop sila. Okay, so that will be their accomplishment for that specific semester. Okay, however, okay, we can't just invade a community and do whatever we can. Okay, so we must first make a community profile. Okay, it is a comprehensive and structured set of information describing the characteristics of a community. Okay, so it is very important, class, that we know where we are going. Okay, we must also identify what help to give. Okay, a help, okay, that would be beneficial to all. Okay, so take note of that. Okay, so one important thing we should always keep in mind is fieldwork ethics. Okay, so let us bear in mind that while getting information, we must earn the trust of our sources. Okay, so as students, we can learn from CWTS what simple things we can do by starting out with the community. Okay, so it is also good to be exposed in a different environment to learn how other people live their lives. Okay, this may seem easy, class, but should be done systematically, you know? Okay, so with the community profiling, we can really help out easily. Okay, so that is your civic welfare training service. Okay, so let us proceed to the last component of your NSTP, your LTS or Literacy Training Service. Okay, so this refers to the program component designed to train the students to teach literacy and numeracy skills to school children out of the school youth and other segments of society in need of their services. Okay, so meaning your LTS focuses on training to students to become teachers of reading, writing literacy, and numeracy to children. out of school youth and other segments of the society. Teaching unprivileged segments of a society which did not get formal education is a great way class to be of help in building our nation. Okay, so it should be noted by the class that literacy is crucial to the success of individuals in both their career aspirations and in their quality of life. So so it is I think it is more than a basic reading ability, okay, but rather an indication of how adults use written information to function in the society. Okay, so so yung strong literacy skills are closely linked to the probability of having a good job, decent earnings, and access to training opportunities. Okay, so it means that individuals with weak literacy skills are more likely to be what do you call that? Unemployed, or if employed, to be in jobs that pay little. Okay, so ganun ang mangyayari, class. Okay, so that is your literacy training service. Okay, so who are covered by the NSTP law? Okay, so who are covered by the NSTP law? Okay, so all incoming freshman students, male, female, starting school year 2002 to 2003, enrolled in any baccalaureate and in at least 2-year technical, vocational, or associate courses are required to complete one NSTP component of their choice as a graduation requirement. So, before class, for your ROTC component, ang nire-require lang ay yung mga male students. Ngayon class, pati na rin yung mga babae. Okay, so both male and female students. Okay. Enrolled in any baccalaureate and in at least 2-year technical, vocational, or associate courses. Okay. So, yung mga nag-aral ng before the school year 2002 to 2013, 2003, hindi na sila covered ng NSTP law. Okay. So, another is all higher and technical vocational education institution must at least offer one of the NST components. So, lahat ng higher and technical vocational education institution dapat mag-offer ng kahit isa man lang sa mga NSTP component. Okay. State universities and colleges, so dito nabibilang yung MMSU class, shall offer the ROTC component and at least one other NSTP component. Okay, so in MMSU, we offer ROTC and CWTS. Okay. The Philippine Military Academy, Philippine Merchant Marine Academy, Philippine National Police Academy, and other SUCs of similar nature, in view of the special character of these institutions, are exempted from the NSTP. Okay? So, yung nature ng ginagawa kasi class ng Philippine Military Academy, parang yung ginagawa rin ng mga nagtitrain sa ROTC. Okay? So, they are exempted from the NSTP. Okay? So, private higher education and technical vocational education institutions with at least 350 student cadets or cadets may offer the ROTC component and consequently establish or maintain a Department of Military Science and Tactics subject to the existing rules and regulations of the AFP. Okay, so meaning pag less than 350 yung students, you are not permitted to have an ROTC component. Okay, so those are the things covered by the NSTP law. Okay, so what is the duration and equivalent course unit of each of the NSTP component? Okay, so each of the NSTP components shall be undertaken for an academic period of 2 semesters for 54 to 90 training hours per semester. Okay, so in MMSU class, for every semester, okay, you need to render 54 hours. Okay, so for 2 semesters, you need to render 108 hours. Okay, so it shall be credited for 3 units per semester. Okay. So, who are covered by the suspension of the ROTC requirement? Okay, so the completion of ROTC training as a requisite for graduation is set aside for students who have completed all their academic requirements for their respective courses as certified by the school on or before the effectivity of the NSTP Act of 2001, which is March 23, 2002. Okay, the concerned students may apply for graduation in their respective school. So, as I have said a while ago class, yung mga nagtapos before the school year 2002 to 2003 ay hindi covered ng RA 9163. Okay, so what happens to male students who are currently enrolled and have not taken nor completed the ROTC requirements for graduation? Okay, male students, okay, who are not covered by section 12 of this rule and are currently enrolled but have not taken any of the military service, civic welfare service or law enforcement service, okay, shall be covered by the NSTP law. So this is from the old Republic Act. Okay, so male students who have completed 2 semesters of the expanded ROTC or National Service Program are deemed to have complied with the NSTP requirement. Okay, so nakapag-complete na siya ng 2 semesters. So, he is compliant with the NSTP requirement. Okay, third is male students who are not covered by Section 12 of these rules and have taken only 1 semester of basic ROTC shall take any of the NSTP components to qualify for graduation. So, dapat makompleto niya yung 2 semesters. The students who want to qualify for enlistment in the reserve force or attend the advanced ROTC program shall undertake a special program for this purpose. Okay. Now, what if the NSTP component of my choice is not offered in my school? Okay? So, meaning, kung hindi siya offered sa school ninyo, okay, so, you have to cross-enroll. Okay, so how is cross-enrollment done? Schools that do not meet the required number of students to maintain the optional ROTC and any of the NSTP components or do not offer the component chosen by the student shall allow their students to cross-enroll in other schools irrespective of whether such school is under CHED or TESDA. And in the case the students taking the ROTC component, irrespective of whether the 2 semesters shall be taken from different schools whose ROTC is managed by different branches of service of the AFP. Okay, so that is how to cross-enroll. As I have mentioned ago, class, private higher and technical vocational education institution may also offer the ROTC if they have at least 350 cadet or cadet students. Okay. So, that is how cross-enrollment is done. So, what is NSTP One Summer Program? Okay, so NSTP OSP is created under Republic Act 9163 or the NSTP Act of 2001, especially Section 6 and jointly devised, formulated, and adapted by DND, CHED, and TESDA. Okay? Okay, so this one summer program is a substitute of the 2 semesters program which is designed, formulated, and adapted by these three, DND, CHED, and TESDA. Okay? However, this is subject to the capability of the school. Okay. So, last is what is the National Service Reserve Corps or NSRC? Okay, so NSRC is created under Section 11 of RA 9163 or the NSTP Act of 2001, composed of graduates of the non-ROTC components. Okay, so we have the CWTS and LTS. Okay, members of this corps may be tapped by the state for literacy and civic welfare activities through the joint efforts of DND, CHED, and TESDA. Okay, so meaning your NSRC are composed of graduates of the non-ROTC components. So meaning yung CWTS at LTS. Okay, so for example, may activities sila sa isang barangay and they want to educate students. Okay, so they may tap the LTS students like that. Okay, so that is the National Service Reserve Corps or NSRC.